Welcome to our YouTube channel. God bless you. You are about to listen to a message from the channel of the Almighty God and the lips of a pastor. The blessings await you as you listen and pray along. For any inquiry, partnership, and prayers, please check our YouTube page for contact as you click the select icon. Please like, subscribe, and click the bell to be notified on upcoming videos. And do not forget to share. God bless you.
I will pray. The Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will come before you because you are the mighty God. As we look at your words today, we touch every life here, those lives across the airwaves in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because I know that you have done it. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. Happy New Year. Welcome to the year 2023, the year of possibilities, the year of preservation, the year of protection, the year of purity, the year of prosperity, the year of grace. We shall be continuing the series on answering the call of the Almighty God, part 1, round 2, with the subtitle, The Spirit of God and Prophetic Anointing. In 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 6, and the Spirit of the Lord will come upon thee, and thou shalt prophesy with them, and shall be turned into another man. Now, the Holy Spirit will speak to us in 2 points. Point number one, the practical experience of the Spirit of God. Point number two, the prophetic experience from the Spirit of God. Now, if you look at that point, the practical experience of the Spirit of God, in 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 6a, and the Spirit of the Lord will come upon thee. Now, if you see somebody is going to visit you, perhaps maybe there was a pre-invitation or there was an agreement. Or if you have to go to a particular destination, there must be a pre-plan or a plan ahead of that kind of journey. The Spirit of the Lord will come upon thee. When we are talking about the visitation of the first citizen of a country or the first citizen of a state, we are talking about the Spirit of creation, the Spirit of the Almighty God coming upon a mortal man. Now, we should therefore draw a conclusion. Why would the Spirit come upon this vessel? Certain things may have happened before then. And you and I, in this study, we have gone through this study and we understood that Prophet Samuel had sessions upon sessions with Saul. The first session we refer to as the school of ministry. He spent time with Saul and he excused the servant away and he spent time impacting certain vital spiritual qualities upon Saul. And the other school that Saul went to was the school of prophecy, the school of prophetic anointing, because he was to witness the prophets coming down, singing with psaltery, with the harp, and the prophesying. It was like the school of prophecy. Now, in the school of ministry, that Prophet Samuel took Saul through, down certain lessons or certain activities, spiritual activities may have taken place. Number one, the cleansing of self. Number two, the purity of purpose and heart. Number three, fresh dew from above. Number four, increased love of God. And then number five, motivation for God's services. Because those sessions that Prophet Samuel was having with Saul, there was this exercise of the cleansing of self, making to realize God is ultimate, God is almighty, God is holy. And there was a purity of purpose and heart. It was indirectly and directly taking Saul through a spiritual exercise, a spiritual school to prepare him to be king over Israel. And then there was a time too. Saul was going to meet with the prophet because this was foretold that Saul was going to meet with the prophet. And in that experience, he will have the understanding of humility of the prophets. You see the prophets? They were not like, hey, fine, we have the choristers over there. We are the prophets sitting in a very highbrow seat. They were with instruments serving the Lord. Number two, understanding of the simple lifestyle of the prophets. Number one, understanding of humility of the prophets. Understanding of the simple lifestyle of the prophets. Number three, the dynamics of giving God the glory. Number four, the art, the signs, and the spirituality of pouring praises to the Almighty God in song rendition. Number five, the pure flow of the gift of prophecy when in the right spiritual standing with the Almighty God. Now, you see all of this that was to happen to Saul. because he was prophesying to him, you will see this prophet, and they'll be coming down, and they will sing, and they will do this, and they will do that, and all of that. Saul was being prepared to be a spiritually equipped king over Israel. He had been to the school of ministry, and he was told that he will also be enrolled into the school of prophecy or the prophetic anointing after leaving Samuel. We shall be looking at the preconditions to experiencing the spiritual gift, such as the gift of prophecy. The preconditions. Number one, we should understand that while Saul was with Samuel, there was spiritual cleansing going on. There was a revisit of who God was or who God is. There was this impartation of what God likes and what God doesn't like from Prophet Samuel unto Saul. And we can liken that now in our dispensation as being born again, being saved, being purified in heart, and getting ready for the spirit visitation. Now, some of us will just feel that when we speak in tongues, gives us the power or makes us feel as if the Spirit of God has visited us. And so we forget the steps we should take, the salvation experience, the purification of the heart experience, and all of that, preparing yourself, your body, your soul, waiting until the visit of the Holy Spirit, and want to jump the gun and say, right now, I think we are baptized with the Holy Ghost. I think the Spirit of God has come. Before the Spirit of God will come upon you, you must prepare your house. And what is your house? Your body must be clean. Your soul must be prepared. Your heart must long after him, and then he will come and find a place in your heart. The prayer points for you and I are, let us pray to be imparted with the spiritual blessings in the school of ministry. Let us pray to be imparted with the spiritual blessings of the school of prophetic anointing. In Proverbs chapter 20, verse 27, the spirit of man is the candle of the Lord, searching all the inward parts of the belly. God sees your heart. He sees our hearts. He sees everything within us, because our spirits are the candles of the Lord. Your spirit is the candle of the Lord. If your heart is judging you, your heart is telling you this, you have not done wrong, it's like you are blowing the trumpet, blaring the whole thing out spiritually, and everybody can hear you spiritually. So you see, your spirit is the candle of the Lord, and is searching all the inward parts of the heart. If you want the Spirit of God to visit you, you will search your heart. Lord, is there something in my life that is not pleasing to you? Have mercy. Is there something in my hands that I'm doing that is not pleasing? Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy upon me. Forgive me my sins. Cleanse me. All my desires that are impure, Lord, have mercy. Everything I've cocked up within me, Lord, have mercy. Forgive me every sin. And as you prepare yourself, as you ask the Lord to cleanse you, as you prepare yourself in this manner, then indeed you'll be ready for the visit of the Holy Spirit. But if you say, these things in my life, these lies in my soul, this immorality in my hands do not matter because it is one of those things, then the Spirit of God will not come. What will come upon that soul is an evil spirit. And you see, some persons are visited by evil spirits and they think the Spirit of God has visited them. And you see them moving here and there, talking as though they're talking from the inspiration of God, whereas they're talking from the inspiration of the devil. So you need to cleanse your life, cleanse your heart, wash everywhere clean. Imagine the president is to visit your house. I'm sure you are going to refurbish the entire house. You repent, right? You paint, you spray, you clean everything clean. You call household cleaners, they will take care of everything. You put your red rugs everywhere, perfume here and everything. Everything will be looking wonderfully, so that when he comes, he will be impressed. So if you want God Almighty, who is greater than the president of your country, to visit your life, to come into your life, then you must be ready. Everything swept, all the evil swept, all the lies repented from, and every evil in your life, you take everything off your heart, and God will see that your spirit indeed is right with him, and they will visit you. And the prayer points for you and I, let us pray to receive from the Almighty God as we desire to please him. Let us pray not to be cajoled with the counterful gift of prophecy. And the Lord will help you, because today the Lord will touch everyone. Selection action point number one, you will receive the Spirit of God when you have been cleansed of sins by the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Selection action point number two, when the Spirit of God comes upon a man, he will be transformed into another man. Selection action point number three, you cannot expect from the Almighty God when you deliberately refuse to follow his instructions. for spiritual blessings. So that's your point number four. The Almighty God is ready to use you if you tell Him that you are willing. So this is your point number five. The Almighty God has made provision for your spiritual blessings if you are ready in your heart to receive. And the question to you and I is, are you born again? Are you saved? Are you purified in heart? Are you sanctified? Are you baptized by the Holy Spirit? Are you spirit-filled? If that is not the case, it means that you are not ready for the supernatural yet. But if that is the case with you, congratulations, the Lord will touch you. Today, if you have not been saved, you get saved. Today, if you have not been sanctified, get sanctified. Today, if your heart is right with God and you have not been baptized with the Holy Spirit, the Lord will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. And when the Lord comes upon you, the only evidence that you know that you have been baptized, that we know, the first evidence that we have is the ability to speak in a known tongue. You may not be shouting or singing it here or praying it here. Maybe when you go to God to pray alone and something comes upon you, you have the ability to speak in another tongue. That is the first evidence. And there are other evidences that will come alongside. And the Lord will help you right now. Let's go right away to business. If you have not been born again, open your mouth now. Let you say, Lord, have mercy upon me. Forgive me my sins. Write my name in the book of life. Have mercy upon my soul. 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 If you are not be born again, pray, 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 pray. Father, in Jesus' name, an individual that has not been born again, let us pray that prayer sincerely. Write is your name in the book of life. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because I know that you have done it. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Now, if you have not been purified in your heart, the lusting of our opposite says, you are thinking evil about other people, ask the Lord to cleanse your heart right now. Open your mouth, say, Lord, cleanse my heart, purify my heart, purify my intentions, keep me holy in the heart. Lord, help me. 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 And if you pray that prayer, the Lord will sanctify your soul. Father, in Jesus' name, every individual here, all the individuals across the airways, you asking for purification of the heart, give and grant unto them in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because I know that you have done it. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. If you have not been baptized with the Holy Spirit, and then you want the fullness of God to come upon your life, the Lord is ready to do it for you right now, right here, right now. It's there close to you. If you have been saved, you have been purified, the Holy Spirit is just there close to you. It will just enter you and give the power to speak in a known tongue. The power, you can speak it here, you can speak it after now, after wherever you are. Open your mouth in faith and the Lord will fill it up. It's not the tongues that you have memorized or you hear people say. The Lord will fill it up, fill it up, fill it up. Baptize you right now in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray as many that have not been baptized with the Holy Ghost here and those across the airwaves that have not been baptized and filled with the Spirit of God, grant unto them in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because I know that you have answered. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, we thank you for the year 2023. We thank you for your people that you have purchased by the blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord, these people you have purchased, oh Lord, will be kept protected, preserved, purified, oh Lord, throughout the entire year, in Jesus' name. Death will not visit them. Preservation will be their lot. Prosperity will be their experience. Oh Lord, I pray, purification will be their daily interest. In Jesus' name. Whatever detonation of bombs, oh Lord, on the engagement of evil spirit to manslaughter will not come near their dwelling places. Lord, they will be protected in the marketplaces, in the open places, at the hubs, at the malls, in their houses, on the street. Nothing evil will come upon them in Jesus' name. Lord, as a desire in their hearts, according to your word, Lord, there will be fruition and realization of those desires in prayers in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because I know that you have answered. Lord, we'll pray that word protection will cover every ground. Protection against acid bath, protection against gun attack, protection against machete attack, protection against strangling, whatever evil intention or machinations, Lord, I pray they are protected in Jesus' name. That word preservation will preserve their soul from sickness, the sickness that will lead them to death, the lesion that would lead them to deformity. Lord, there will preservation. Preservation of their soul. Preservation of their soul. Oh Lord, that word purification will make their heart be dear to you from time to time. Heaven will hear their heart voices, will hear their heart cries. Lord, we pray that we will become channels and lights unto the world wherever they are, in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray the hand of God, the power of God, that word power, oh Lord, will be their experience. It is seen in the name of Jesus. The word will be carried out expeditiously in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray the demonstration of your power. This demonstration of your power and your presence will be upon their lives in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because I know that you have done it. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. God bless you.
Thanks for listening to the message. The blessings await you as you obey and pray along. For any inquiry, partnership, and prayers, please check our YouTube page for contact as you click on the select icon. Please like, subscribe, and click the bell to be notified on upcoming videos. And do not forget to share. God bless you.